您现在收看的是华视教育文化频道，
接下来要播出的是英文文法与修辞二。
同学大家好，欢迎再次收看英文文法与修辞。我们这周要讲的是第十二讲次 Imagined Conditional 和过去事实相反的假设语气。那我们很高兴这周 Steven 老师还是能够加入我们。
Hello everybody, good to be back.
好，现在我来为同学讲解单元目标。我们这周是希望帮助同学理解英文它与过去发生事实相反的时候，它假设语气该怎么样构造，怎么样写。然后我们还要探讨英文其他类似的英语表达方式。我们知道假设语气中，当我们要表达和过去发生事实相反的时候，我们用以下的这个句法来表达。我们要用过去完成式 plus 加上 would have加上过去分词。 would 是过去式，然后 have 也是一个完成式，所以都是用过去完成式。那我们看例句， If I had known Renee was in the hospital， 假如我过去知道 Renee 她在医院， I would have gone to visit her， 那我当时就会去 visit her， 就去看她。那这个 conditional clause 在前面， consequence 在后面。这边要注意的就是说，事实上我过去并不知道，我那当时不知道那个 Renee 住院，所以我没有去探病。那我们也可以用 wish 加上过去完成式来表达对过去想做没有做的事情的遗憾。我们举例来看， I wish I had gone to visit her， 啊，真希望我当时有去看他。好，我们现在要请 Steven 老师帮我们朗读课文。
To express and imagine the situation, we use the past perfect tense in the conditional clause and would plus have plus the past participle in the consequence clause. The following are some examples.Renee was diagnosed with stomach cancer and was hospitalized for an operation. Her friend Maria didn't know this, so Maria didn't go to visit her. When Maria learned this from a mutual friend, she said, If I had known Renee was diagnosed with cancer, I would have gone to visit her. The real situation was that Maria didn't know about it. Therefore, she didn't go visit Renee in the hospital. Not if I would have known you were in the hospital, I would have gone to visit you. Don't use would in the conditional if clause. If I had worked hard, I'd have passed the entrance examination. In spoken English,We often abbreviate would to apostrophe D. I'd have rented your car if I had known that you had one to rent. Omit the comma between the two clauses when the consequence clause is before the if clause. If I had met Matthew earlier, I'd have married him. In spoken English, I would can be contracted.Into I'd. I wish I had met Matthew earlier. When we feel sorry that something didn't happen, we will say, I wish it had happened. Not, I wish I would have married Matthew. Don't use would after wish. Compare the following three sentences. If I had a lot of money, I would be happy. The fact is, I don't have much money, therefore I am not happy now. If I had had a lot of money, I would have been happy. The fact was that I did not have a lot of money, therefore I was not happy then. If I had had a lot of money, I might have been happy. If I had had a lot of money, perhaps I would have been happy. Nana didn't tell me about her problem. If she had told me about her problem, I could have helped her. Could can be used in the main clause. If I had studied harder for the college entrance examination, I might have been admitted to National Taiwan University. Might can be used in the main clause. In spoken English, have after could or might is pronounced like of. If I were you, I would have accepted that job offer and moved to Hawaii. We can mix a present condition with a past result. If you were that man, who would you have decided to save? Your mother or your wife? If you had won the lottery, you would have a totally different life now. We can mix a past condition with a present result. If Jerry hadn't traveled to Taipei, he would not be able to buy this dream house now.
好，谢谢 Steven 老师。我们休息一下，待会我为同学讲解课文。好，我们现在来看课文。Conditional, imaginal, imagined, conditional 就与过去事实不合的一个条件句哈。To express an imagined situation 要来传达一个我们虚拟的、想象的，就是和过去事实不符合、想象纯粹想象的一个 situation 情况的话 ，we use a past perfect tense。In the conditional clause, 我们用过去 perfect tense, perfect, 哈，我们有的时候形容词应该讲说it's perfect, 很完美好极了。可是这边在文法上它就是当作完成式。好，这个要请同学注意就一般的用法perfect, it's perfect, but 这边文法用法是当完成式。在这个 conditional clause, 就是条件句里面我们要用过去完成式，然后另外一边也是用过去式哈，可是要用 would 加上 have 加上过去分词 participle 这个式子分词，我们通常就是过 have 的话 ，would 是过去式，加上 have 就过去完成，再加上分词，这是我们过去完成式的标准用法哈。在这个 consequence clause 在结果句里面，所以有两个子句，条件句、结果句。那我们下面看一些例子 ，following are some example。这个例子第一个举的是 ，Renee was diagnosed with stomach cancer。好，这个 Renee 哈，瑞妮她是 diagnosed with。我们通常讲说 ，diagnose 它是指说医生诊断。那习惯上你诊断出来有什么病的话一定是用 with 这个介系词 be diagnosed with some disease 那这边的话这个片语同学要画起来 be diagnosed with 尤其介系词要用 with 不要用 in 啊或者 on 或者其他的任何好 be diagnosed with 那这个 stomach cancer 癌症有很多我们讲这 stomach cancer 然后脑癌长脑瘤的 现在手机哈，我像我们对面的那些邻居哈，有蛮多邻居，还有学校的同仁，很多是 brain cancer 脑子 BRAIN brain cancer 哈，那胃癌哈，那各种的癌的话，那鼻咽癌怎样，就等等的话，我们都知道说那 cancer 前面加上另外一个字，代表你身体的器官哪个部分它长癌了哈。好 ，and was hospitalized。那我们再注意这个哈，他被医生诊断胃癌，然后 hospitalized， 看这个字，他我们讲过字首字根字尾，他的原来的字根是 hospital， 这是医院名词，再加上 ize， 是把它名词转变成动词，再加上 d 的话，就把它变成过去式 be hospitalized， 就是。我们讲 hospital 是名词，医院，然后住院治疗，我们就是 hospitalize。那我们想想看，同学既然学过字首字根字尾，我们讲说这可以让你一下单字增加数十倍哈，有好多字后面都是加上 ize， 像我们讲说summary s u m m a r y， 我们做一个，我们说 summarize the story， 把这个故事哈。用 in 300 words， 用300个字来 summary， 就是做一个简单的那个概要说。那这个 summary 要把它变成动词的话，也是 summarize， 把后面的 y 去掉，加上 ize， 所以很多很多字，像 nature， 自然 naturalize， 非常多字都是这样子哈。同学可以自己想想看，怎么样增加你的单字。不讲说增加数十倍，至少增加一个三五倍哦。很多都是名词啊，或是形容词后面加 ize， 然后他住院治疗 ，for 是代表原因理由，为什么住院呢 ？For an operation 的话就是动手术。那要注意这个 operation 它是 all 是一个母音，前面的话我们讲说动一个手术，我们。中文就是动词手术了哈，英文要注意，它一定要用 an， 因为后面接的这个名词 operation 那个 all 是一个母音。好，他住院动手术。Her friend Maria， 他的朋友玛丽亚 didn't know this， 不知道这件事情，就是指他说，胃癌，然后住院治疗动手术。So Maria didn't go to visit her。所以玛丽亚没有去医院 visit her， 有的时候说是拜访哈，可是这边的话当然就是指探病，没有去医院探病。When Maria learned this， 玛丽亚知道这件事情 ，this 就是指她那个胃癌住院治疗这件事情，她知道这件事情 from a mutual friend， from。从什么什么得知 ？From a friend， 这个 friend 还要增加讲说 mutual friend， 就彼此都知道朋友。我们双方 mutual friend， 我们 mutual 其实有很多，我们说彼此的了解 mutual understanding， 然后 mutual friend， 这个 mutual 这个字也经常用的哈。那个还有共同基金 mutual fund 等等，这个字后面也接很多。我们看报章杂志经常用这个 mutual。She said， 然后他就说。If I had known Renee was diagnosed with cancer， 假如，记住这边用的是过去完成式。If I had known， 假如我过去当时知道 Renee 她被诊断出来有癌症 ，diagnosed with cancer， I would have gone to visit her。那这边这个我当时会也是要用过去完成式 would 加上 have。加上过去分词 ，I would have gone， 我当时就会去 visit her， 探病。那这个条件句是在前面，这个 consequence 这个结果句在这个后面。我们看，这都是假设语气。The real situation， 真实的状况是什么呢 ？Was that Maria didn't know about it。Maria 她真实状况说她并不知道 it 是指这一件事情 Renee 生病住院 therefore 因此所以因此因而 she didn't go visit Renee in the hospital， 所以他没有去拜访瑞尼，去医院里面探病 in the hospital。 然后这个星号是说这个句子下面这个句子哈，前面有个星号，在文法上告同学说这个句子是错误的，是同学经常在写作上犯的错误，我们就提醒同学，就是 If I would have known you were in the hospital, I would have gone to visit you。 这边就是提醒同学 Don't use would，不要用 would 在这个条件 if 子句里面，不要说 if I would have 没有这样子哈， if I had known 就这个 would 不要用，条件句里面不用 would。 然后我们再看下一个例句， if I had worked harder， 假如我 work 工作 hard 就是指努力，我努力，假如我 work hard，我努力工作，就努力更努力的用功哈。然后 hard 就是指努力工作、努力学习、很努力。然后 I'd 是指 I would I'd have passed the entrance exam， 那我当时就可能会 pass。 我们像同学每次讲啊，希望我的那个期末考都 OPA， 那我同学大概 OPA 事实上就说全部都能够通过，就及格。那这边讲说，假如我当时哈努力学习，那我现在我就 would have passed the entrance exam， 我就会现在的话就会当时努力，那我一定就会通过入学考试。那这个考试 exam examination， 就我们通常它的长就是完整的字应该是 examination。那我们这边通常把它缩写哈，就 exam 哈，那是考试。那后面会用 in 或是 on 的一个介系词。好，那我们再看这个，in spoken English 口语里面，我们通常哈 ，we often use the to replace would。口语里面我们通常用would 那个的哈。Would 那个 would 就省略掉，只有一个的这个字哈。好，我们来看这个例句 ，I'd 就是 I would。I'd have rented your car if I had known that you had one to rent。我哈，要是当时知道你有车出租，我就当时就租了你的车。那要记住 ，omit 就是指。省略 rent 的话就是出租，租房子、租车子，通通都是用租，它是动词。可是当名词的时候就是租金，很好用的，名词动词这个是 同义型，没有改变。好，我们还要提醒同学 omit the comma， 省掉这个 comma 逗号 between the two clauses， 两个子句中间我们省去那个逗号。When the consequent clause is before the if clause， 就结果句在前面 ，if clause if 的子句条件句在后面，我们就把标点符号省略。我们来看一下 ，If I had met Matthew earlier， 假如我当时哈能够早一点遇到马修 ，I'd have married him， 那我当时就会嫁给他了。好 ，In spoken English。Would can be contracted into the， 再强调就是 would 可以 contracted 就是指省略，缩写成的。I wish I had met Matthew earlier。那另外一种讲法就是说啊，期待表示对过去的一种遗憾。我真希望我当时能够更早一点遇到马修。所以 when we feel sorry， 我们觉得很遗憾。That something didn't happen， 那某件事情当时没有发生。I wish it had happened， 真希望它，就用 I wish it had happened， 就是说真希望当时它能够发生。那再一个有星号的句子，也是同学常常有的错误哈。I wish I would have married Matthew， 不要用 I wish I would， 一定就是 I wish I had married Matthew， 那个 would 哈不要用，在 wish 后面不要用。好，我们再看下面一个句子。 compare the following three sentences. 下面有三个句子，我们第一个看 If I had a lot of money, 假如我有很多钱 I would be happy. 那这边的话是跟现在事实相反。那 The fact is that I don't have money. 事实是我现在没有钱。Therefore, I'm not happy now. 我现在不快乐。这是跟现在事实的相反的。那我们下面一个句子就是跟过去事实相反。If I had had a lot of money, I would have been happy. 就假如我过去有很多钱的话，那我就可能会过去会很快乐。所以呢，事实是说 I didn't have a lot of money. 我 didn't 过去没有很多钱，因此 I was not happy then. 所以我当时并不快乐。好，这是第一个比较，就是说与现在事实不合跟与过去事实相反的两种用法。假如我有钱，假如我当时有钱，那我们再看，就是说这 If I had had a lot of money, perhaps I would have been happy. 这时候我们 I might have been happy, 我们可以这样子用。而且 might have 事实上 interchangeable, 就是说我们有的时候也可以用 perhaps, 我可能会，然后我或许会。那这个 would 它比较语气强调一点，然后 might perhaps 比较弱一点。好，我们休息一下，待会再继续讲解。Nana didn't tell me about her problem. Nana, 她没有，这是过去式，她过去没有告诉我她的问题 problem. If she had told me about her problem, 那假如她当时告诉我关于她的，一定这个 tell someone about something, 这要用 about.假如他当时有告诉我他的问题的话 I could have helped her, 就我当时就可能会，我当时就会帮了他，帮他忙。 Could can be used in the main clause, 这边 could 在主要子句里面我们用 could. If I had studied, 我们看例，再一个例句 If I had studied harder for the college entrance exam, 假如我当时 study harder,当时我能够更学习努力更用功 for the college entrance exam, 用功准备什么呢？是用 for 准备这个大学入学考试 college entrance exam, 那 I might have been, 我就可能会被 admitted, 就是入学，就是入学就是进入 admitted to the National Taiwan University, 就可能可以进入台大。然后 might 这个字 can be used in the main clause, 我们注意就是 might 这个字在主要子句里面也可以用。然后再过来我们看 in spoken English, 口语里面 have, after, could, or might is pronounced like of. 所以英文里面口语里面我们这讲的也帮助同学的听力，不只是写作听力。通常这个 could have, could have, could have, might have, 我们这后面的这个have 的话，我们通常变成只有一个 of, could have, could have 变成 could have, could have。 好，再下面一个例句 If I were you, 假如我是你的话 I would have accepted that job offer,我就会接受这个工作 job offer, 就是人家提供你这个工作机会哈。你可以 accept 接受或者 reject reject 哈。那这个 and move to Hawaii, 就当时哈，假如他我可能就会接受这个工作机会，然后 move to Hawaii 就搬到夏威夷去。那这边我们要提醒同学，就 we can mix a present condition, 我们可以混合的用法，就把一个现在的一个条件句和过去的一个 结果把它混合起来使用。我们再看下面一个例句 ：If you were that man, who would you have decided to save？ 假如你是那个人的话，那你当时会决定要救哪一个人呢？你的母亲，或者你的妻子？这个人，男生经常被问的哈。那这个假如母亲跟妻子都在河里面的话，要先救哪一个？那我们这边就是说 present condition 现在的条件 condition， 然后加上过去的一个结果，这是可以混在一起用的哈。If you had won the lottery, you would have a totally different life now。 那这假如你当时哈那个中了，就是中奖发财，那你现在这个生活可能是完全不一样。这边的话 ，we can mix， 我们混合一个过去的条件，假如当时中奖，那跟现在的一个结果，现在我们的生活是完全不一样。所以混合过去条件与现在的结果，这是我们在写作里面也可以看到的。If Jerry hadn't traveled to Taipei， 假如这个杰瑞哈，他当时没有旅行到台北来旅行 ，he would not be able to buy the dream house now。那么他现在的话，就不可能买到他这梦中梦幻式的，就是梦寐以求的这个房子哈 ，dream house。那这边也是过去的一个条件，当时要不是到台北旅行，跟现在的一个结果，现在他买了这个 dream house 哈，所以这也是一个 mixed。我们提醒同学，经常有这种混合在一起的时态。好，那我们今天讲解了这一些，就是总共是第三讲，所以这个 conditional clause 我们的条件句就到这一周结束。我们底下还要有那个我们的 chat room 和 Steven 老师聊天。Okay, Stephen, that for this imaginary and imagined conditional, that would you please that clarify, have further knowledge to share with us?
Part of the difference between the imaginary and the imagined conditional is that in the case of the imagined conditional, we're acknowledging that it didn't happen.But it could have happened. Mm-hmm. It might have happened. It was a real possibility. Whereas with the imaginary conditional, we are much more, we are implying, no way. Mm-hmm. No way could it have happened. And this is part of the reason why the imaginary conditional includes some rather strong statements that were mentioned. Last week, at the end of last week's lecture, such as, I wouldn't seek your help if you were the last person on earth. That's a very strong statement, and it's a, no way, it will never happen. Nah.
所以 imaginary 的话跟 imagined clause 啊 ，imagined。它是代表说，其实假如过去，虽然这个事情是不可能发生，不过假如当时我知道，我当时一定去，所以这当时是有一种比较强的可能性。可是 imaginary 的话，就是代表 no way， 100% 绝对就是不太可能的。就是说，我们像我们举的例子说，即使你是全世界都死光最后一个人，我也不会找你帮忙哈。好，那我们就这一周讲解到这里，谢谢 Steven 老师，也谢谢各位同学的收看，再会。